Hi guys, it's Innovative Idea Girl, and today I'm here back in front of you with another DIY. So today I'm going to be showing you how to make a bookmark in two cute ways, or maybe even more. So let's first start with the materials you'll need for this craft. You will need some tape, some craft foam, and actually this craft foam has, it's like sticky on the back so that you can stick it anywhere. If you don't have that, you can use regular craft foam or paper and just glue it on. But personally, I think that this kind of craft foam works really good. Okay, next thing you're going to need is pom-poms. Amazing, I know, right? So that, you will need some white nail polish or paint, and you will need a bobby pin or a burnt match or any toothpick or something. Next thing you're going to need are some scissors. And you will need a pen. And you will need some cardstock. I have this designer cardstock and I love it. It's really useful and helpful, so I would definitely recommend it. Another thing we're going to need is a hot glue gun. And remember to have adult supervision when using hot objects. Now, without further ado, let's get started with our craft. So I've chosen this stone kind cardstock. I actually thought it was a really good design. So first thing you're going to do, you're going to flip it over so that you have the outside part, the design part facing down, and you're going to make your design for your panda, because that's the first thing we're going to do. So you want to start by making a rectangle, because obviously bookmarks are rectangular shaped or some different shapes, but you can do it any shape you want. And I have chosen to do it the shape of a bookmark. So it's not the best rectangle in the world or anything, but as I'm cutting, I'm going to be fixing my edges to make sure it is perfect. So I'm going to cut this out. So I did it. It is the best I could cut it. I'm not really sure if it's equal or not. So now I'm going to fold it in half so that it ends up looking like this. I want to make sure that the sides are equal, and after that I can actually start, you know, folding the sides and stuff to make sure it's completely equal. So I have this. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some tape off about as wide as the sides of this cardstock, and I'm going to tape it on the sides so that it is, I'm going to tape it on the sides. I have my piece of tape and I'm taping it. Okay. So it ends up like this. I have my tape right here. And now I'm going to fold that piece over so that it holds it. Before putting tape on the other side, I have some excess paper still left over, like I said. I'm going to cut them off so that it is completely equal. And I'm not the best equalizer. I'm not best at like doing the stuff, but I try my best. And I think it looks much better now. So now I can go ahead, take out another piece of tape, and okay. And I can put it on. So right, I'm just putting this piece of tape on and taping it onto the other side. And then and that's the base of your ruler. Now we're going to start with the panda part of this. Okay, so you're going to take your craft foam, and what you want to do is like take a pencil or a pen or something, and you want to start sketching out basically like the panda's head. So I'm going to sketch that out so that I don't mess up, and so that's okay. So I made the best panda shape I could, and now I'm going to cut it out. I actually tried to make the cheeks a little chubby, because pandas are actually really adorable, and they have such chubby cheeks. They literally look like marshmallows, except with black dots on them. But actually, I think pandas are like my favorite animals. Well, I don't really know, because I can list a ton of my favorite animals like nonstop. Because there are so many animals I find just the most adorable. So I have this, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tape it. No, not tape. I'm going to peel off the sticky part of this. And I'm going to put it right there on the top where I'm going to put it on the side that we didn't tape. So the top here. And I'm going to put it on like so. So I get this. Now I'm going to make the other side. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to draw another panda. So what I do is I'm going to cut out this part so that I can just trace this so that I don't have to worry about my pandas have been completely equal. So I have this, and now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to tape the side so that it's like a stencil, and I'm going to keep it safe. So I'm just going to tape it. And there you go. And now I'm going to just trace this on. Okay. I hope this turns out good. Okay, so I did it, and now I'm going to cut it out. And I hope it turns out like equal and good and perfect. Well, obviously I'm not expecting for perfect, but I'm just going to hope for the best. Okay, I got this. Now I'm going to peel it off, and I'm crossing my fingers right now, and I hope that it is. Okay, little problem. I made this ear a little too different. There we go. Now I'm just going to glue. But not glue. Why do I keep on saying glue? I mean, I'm going to just stick that on. So I have my two panda sides right here. Now we're going to start with the next part. Now we're going to need our black craft foam. And I'm going to do, I'm first going to cut the ear part of this. So I'm just going to sketch out, like, So I'm just going to sketch this out now. And I'm going to have so now I'm going to okay, so my eraser doesn't work. That's just okay. So I'm not really this is not really working out good at the moment. I'm like trying my best to make the most perfect panda ears, but it's just not working. So, I'm trying my best. Okay, so I really tried and now I'm worried about how it's going to end up. I'm going to cut out my panda ears. Okay, so I cut out my ears and I put them on both sides of my panda bookmark. And while I was doing that, I actually also set up the face and the eyes and the nose. It was easy. It's not going to take you a long time or anything. I just cut out four ovals and I cut out two circles. And as you can see, the face is like right there. It's like that easy. So now I'm just going to peel that off and I'm going to start putting the eyes and stuff on my panda. So I finished putting the faces on my panda. This one just looks like it has like a squished face, like right, like his eyes are just right there. And then this one is just like, he looks perfect, right? But the thing is, you don't see that sparkle in your eyes like you would see in a panda, right? So, that's where a handy-dandy white nail polish comes in. Yeah, my handy-dandy white nail polish. So, I'm going to use a bobby pin or a hair clip, if you can see that. And I'm going to open up my nail polish. And I'm going to dip this end, the one that's longer, I'm going to dip that into the nail polish, like so. And I am going to take my panda, and I'm going to put, these two little dots on his eyes. So, oh my god, that just makes him look so cute. Okay, I'm going to take a little more and I'm going to put a second dot. To get this. I'm going to do the same for the other eye. The other side of the head, or well, at least it's just two pandas, and okay, so I got that. Now I'm going to actually put a little bit of white on the noses as well, because some pandas have that really cute nose with the little sparkle, and then adorable. Okay, so I got both my faces. Okay, now for the amazing quote that is supposed to brighten your day or something. Okay, so I'm going to close my nail polish. Okay. So, I have my panda and everything, but now the thing is, I don't see anything that's really gonna inspire me when I'm looking at this, right? Okay. I'm going to take my pen and I'm going to write something that's just really, really cute and stuff, and that's gonna make me feel, oh my god, happy. Okay. So, I'm just going to write, let's see, thing. Let's see. Okay, I came up with this adorable quote. Okay, so I wrote on this side, I wrote pandas are the new cute, and oh my god, that's just so hilarious. Okay. For the next slide, let's see. Okay, so I wrote, pandas are chubby marshmallows. Because they're chubby and they look like marshmallows. Like I said before. Okay, so, now I'm going to take my hot glue gun and I'm going to plug it in. Like I said before, please be careful if you're using the hot objects, because hot objects can burn. So always have adult supervision if you're not used to this kind of stuff, or if you're not really allowed to use it by yourself. So I'm going to plug my hot glue gun in, and so while my hot glue gun is getting hot and heated up, I'm going to take my pom-pom bag, and I'm going to take out two white pom-poms, right? So I have these two white pom-poms. What are we going to do with this is your question. We're going to put them like right here on the side, like on the bottom, to make it look like the pandas are like having little hands or something, like held up. Can you see that? You can't? Don't worry. Once we start, I'll make sure you see. I'm not deciding to do the same for the other side because when we put it in the book, it will cause a problem. Might not, depends. Anyways, I am going to take my hot glue gun. Hot glue guns take a pretty long time to heat. So my hot glue gun's heated, and now I'm just going to glue on my pom-poms. So I did it, and this was our first bookmark. Now I'm going to show you the second bookmark, and so we're going to do the same procedure for that. So I'm just going to give you that time to do the same thing, and then I'll go on from there. Okay, so I finished this, and for this one, as you can see, I did unicorns. So adorable. So I finished my unicorns, and now what we're going to do, I'm going to use markers, take them out of my emoji art travel kit that I recently showed in my videos, and if you want to see it, you can search it up and you will find it right on my channel. So I am going to take bright, beautiful colors. Okay, and this. Okay, so I took about like, okay, so I took 5-6 colors. These are double-sided markers, so they have the ends. So what I'm going to use this for is the unicorn's horns. I'm going to put lines on them so that they look really pretty. I'm not really sure how many colors I'll be able to fit, but I hope I can fit many. Okay, now I'm really getting worried. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, at least one more fit in there. Oh well. I fitted in as much as I could. And I'm just going to color my unicorn's hair. Add some pizzazz to them. Right, adding beautiful bright colors. So I got my colors going. So I have my colors going right now. I'm using the most prettiest colors I can. I am literally loving this unicorn bookmark. That's probably my favorite. And even though I said pandas were my favorite and stuff, I have to say, depending on how cute this one is, depending on how good this one is, depending on how good this one is, I am coloring it, and you know, and I am literally loving it. I think it is much better in design and stuff, and I really couldn't have done a better job. I am loving how creative these are. I've never done something like this in my whole entire life. So I did the first part. As you can see, I added some rainbow colored hair and stuff and colored the horn. Now I am going to color with some other colors. I'm going to color the other unicorns. Yeah, I literally made two unicorns because I just found it a lot more pretty. So, I'm using pretty colors and they are looking fabulous. Okay, I'm going to use dark purple. I want to use beautiful colors, right? Now I can color with those beautiful colors. Funnest thing I've ever done. Okay, so I have used dark purple, which doesn't look like dark purple at all. So now I have almost finished this, and I am not even coloring in the order. So I finished my unicorn bookmark, and these are the results of how they ended out. On the unicorn bookmark, I wrote two quotes: rainbows brighten my day, and always be colorful. So, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. It is waiting for you right down below the video. And please, just go on ahead and click on that subscribe button to get notifications on my most latest videos. And I will see you on the next video, guys. Bye!